We are going to Naples to check on a few pizzeria because I heard that the best pizzaiolo in the world lives in Naples.
No, attualmente il migliore pizzaiolo al mondo è a Caiazzo, che è a 3
chilometri
da qui.
Guys, I don't know if you remember that part from the Italian episode of the mozzarella making series. When I was in the car, something just slipped out of Benito's mouth. He said, and I quote, "The best pizzeria in the world is not in Naples." What? It's in Caiazzo. Well, never heard of Caiazzo before, so I'm gonna get there. What's up, guys? Salut! Today I'm looking, today we are looking because I'm with Victor. Salut, Victor! We are looking for the best pizza, not in Caserta, not in Italy, but in the world. So the name of the pizzeria is called Pepe Ingrani, and it's owned by a guy called, sorry, I'm just out of breath. Breath. And it's owned by a guy named Franco Pepe. It's supposed to be the best pizzaiolo in the world, the most creative pizza in the world. You get the point.
Questo è il centro antico di Caiazzo.
Sei a Caiazzo?
Sì, abito da 20 anni, ma io...
Il più antico di Caiazzo. Pepe Ingrani è la più buona,
sì,
pizzeria di tutto Italia? No.
Italia, Europa.
Europa, mondo.
Sì, vedi? Pepe Ingrani.
Oh sì, oggi siamo aperti.
Sinistra.
Grazie mille. Ciao, arrivederci. So nice to meet somebody who's just willing to guide us. The guy has nothing to do with the pizzeria. He's just walking by and telling us where the best pizza joint in the world is.
Ciao. Franco Bibe.
Grande.
Franco Bibe?
Sì, sì.
Why? Victory! Yeah, we are probably the luckiest in the world.
Pepe Ingrani, se tu dici che si aspettano, noi mo stiamo facendo prima, mi fa piacere dopo parlare un po' con loro e fargli degustare una pizza.
Oh là là! Can you actually believe we were walking down the street talking about pizza and we stumble upon the guy himself, Franco Pepe? So we got 1 hour before we can enjoy those beautiful pizza because the guy is just not available until then, whatever. So I thought we could just take the opportunity and just share a few reasons with you about why this place is supposed to be the most amazing pizzeria in the world. First reason why, it's not exactly a reason, it's more likely to be a consequence, but still, 1,296 reviews. Second amazing fact, the family of the owner, Franco Pepe, has been baking in Campania, so this region, for 3 generations. So the guy was trained using the authentic way, you know, very traditional Neapolitan pizza. He mastered it and now the guy is completely free. He has no limits, he's super creative. I mean, that's exactly what I love, my man. To be honest, I'm a bit nervous because I don't know exactly what to expect from a guy who is very creative, just a bit wild. You know what I mean. But I think it's for the best. Yeah!
Prego, prego, vieni.
Super, grazie. I can't believe this is happening. Che mozzarella è questa?
Mozzarella di bufala.
Ah, di bufala?
E poi c'è il fior di latte, tutte e due.
Everything is from Caiazzo.
Sì, questo è pienolo del Vesuvio, un altro pomodoro.
Del Vesuvio.
Assaggia.
Boh.
Puoi mangiare la pizza adesso?
Sì.
Prepara quella da due là.
Ah, perfetto. Okay, I'm gonna set you guys right here so that you can enjoy the whole experience. Oh, wee! Un bicchiere di vino rosso. My Italian level is getting better and better, especially when it comes to food. That's always the field of expertise where I get better faster. Grazie mille.
Cono cibo. È un piccolo liquido, viene fritto, viene farcito con una fonduta di grana padano stagionato 12 mesi, c'è del pesto di rucola e all'uscita aggiungiamo dell'oliva di varietà cagliazzana.
It is so light! It feels like, you know, biting into a cloud. The dough is just mind-blowing. Funny thing is that... So the funny thing is that it's an appetizer, but I get the feeling of a dessert. You know that round, luscious, sexy feeling.
Margherita
mozzarella di bufala doppio,
sì.
Passata di pomodoro riccio, riduzione di basilico.
La deconstruzione di margherita.
Degustazione.
To me, doesn't look like a pizza margherita. Not even close. Why? Does he do this? The answer probably is in the tasting. And why not? Three things about this pizza. It is the lightest pizza I've ever had. It is the most creative pizza I've ever seen. And third, it is the best margherita I've ever tasted.
Do I need to say more? I don't need to say more.
I need to take one more, that's what I need to do. We already had two. It doesn't seem to be slowing down.
This is the Scarpetta's pizza. We have the cheese supreme. 12 months season, 3 typologies of tomato, basil, calzone, panzarola di cibo, we have two temperatures in this pizza, hot and cold.
Okay. Grazie. You get only a little blob of red, and yet it blasts with tomato. This is just nothing like you ever tasted before. There is something that can't be described.
What?
Okay. This is the third pizza. Is this the pizza? I love anchovies so much.
I'm already full.
Pizzomola di cocca del Vesuvio, ricotta di bufala, nocciole, polvere di lire caiazzano.
Ok.
Vai, prima, mangia.
I love caper, I love anchovies so much. This is the guy feeding me. Je vais mourir par contre. Wow. Feel like I just came out of a roller coaster. You know, when you're feeling very happy but still a bit dizzy, that's exactly how I feel right now. I love anchovies so much. So it's been 2 days since I ate at Pepe in Grani. The experience was so intense that I needed some time off just to process everything. So in Napoli I've been eating many pizza, so many pizza, too many pizza, not too many pizza, plenty pizza. Some of them are very traditional, some of them are quite innovative, but in fact nothing is quite like what Franco Beppe does. All the way to the point that it's almost disturbing. Can you still call this a pizza? What is pizza? Why is pizza? Where is pizza? How is pizza? Well, at the end, you know, the answer to all those questions is probably very personal. And that's why I can't be the only judge right here. So I'm basically asking you the question, is this the best pizzeria in the world? Tell me what you think in the comments down below. Well, so guys, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give this video a big thumbs up, like it, and share that over your social media. You know how it works. Spread it like butter. Last people, click subscribe because I make new videos every week. It's always about the food. It's always about broadening your horizons. Take care. Bye-bye. Ciao. Salut.